But what happens, Arthur? You go to people's houses and what?
We give them a murder mystery experience. They find a body, look for clues, and try to work out who done it. You know, like Agatha Watsit with Hercule Biro and Mrs. Marbles.
Who are you playing tonight? Chief Inspector? You've shot up through the ranks. Imagine a world where that could happen.
Bullen, you have to.
Shouting again? This is shouting.
He's going to notice. He's not an idiot.
Well, it's all very impressive, Arthur.
Thanks, John. This'll show bloody Martin Clunes.
I'm sorry?
Martin Clunes.
What about him?
Don't like him. He knocked into me once in Curry's when we were both after the same meat thermometer. Took half the skin off the back of my hand because of his abnormally long fingernails. I'll have that till the day I die. Plus, he's got no range. He's always either a vet or a doctor. I've been a bishop, a chauffeur, an international swimmer.
And what do they have in common, all these great roles? Have you told them?
They're all hugely challenging parts.
They're all dead.
And dead, yes. They have all passed away.
I saw the website. He plays the victim in all of them.
Well, it's true that I specialise in the recently annihilated. Terry tells me we've had some very strong reviews on TripAdvisor. And tonight's one has a little bit of a twist. My character, Chief Inspector Gregson, gets too close to the truth.
So he's killed. All he does is lie down on the floor. And I bet he can't even do that.
It's not as easy as it sounds, Boland.
No acting is easy for you. You are not an actor. And you lot, you encourage him. It's cruel.
For your information, I've become known for characters going through the process of rigor mortis. Ask around. Oh, yes. I think you'll find everyone's talking about my stiff parts. What are you smiling at?